Good morning, dear farmers. Welcome to your favorite program, Smart Farming. Every farmer desires to get profit from cultivation of crop. But here, question of ours is how to achieve this. Yes, we have answer for this. That is cultivation of jackfruit. Jackfruit has high potential of value addition. Hence, it has good demand of market in India. Once these are planted, they can generate income throughout their lifetime. Today, we have a panel of 6 experts from various institutions to explain us about various cultural practices of jackfruit cultivation. So, dear farmers, let us introduce them to you. He is Dr. Sandeep Kumar, Principal Scientist from Indian Institute of Soil Science, Bhopal, and he has a working experience of more than 20 years in the field of soil microclimate. I welcome you, sir, to this program. Next, he is Dr. Saurav Swami, Principal Scientist from Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore, and he has the experience of more than 15 years in the field of horticulture sciences. I welcome you, sir, to this program. And he is Dr. Shiva, Principal Scientist from Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi, and he has specialized in the area of post-harvest technology, and he has a working experience of more than 20 years in this area. I welcome you, sir, to this program. Next, he is Dr. Ravi Kishore, Principal Scientist from National Bureau of Plant Genetic Research, New Delhi. He is a well-renowned plant conservation specialist working in this area for the last 12 years. I welcome you, sir, to this program. Next, she is Dr. Tarani Das, Principal Scientist from Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi. And she has been working in the field of horticulture entomology for the last 25 years. I welcome you, madam, to this program. Next, he is Dr. Vijay Rakesh Reddy, Principal Scientist from Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi, and he has specialized in the area of value addition aspects of different horticulture commodities, and he has working experience of more than 15 years in this area. I welcome you, sir, to this program. Now, dear farmers, let us hear more from our experts. Dr. Sandeep Kumar, what are the soil and climatic requirements suitable for jackfruit cultivation?
Thank you, Mr. Srinivas. Actually, deep rich alluvial and red laterite soil with slightly acidic condition with pH ranging from 6 to 6.5 and good drainage are ideal for jackfruit cultivation. Regarding to climatic requirement, jackfruit prefers warm humid climate of hilly slope and hot humid climate of plains. The optimum temperature for cultivation of this crop is 22 to 35 degrees centigrade, and it cannot tolerate both frost as well as drought conditions. The west coast plain with high humidity are found highly suitable for this crop.
Thank you, Dr. Sandeep Kumar, for giving your valuable information. Now I request Dr. Ravi Kishore, can you tell about the propagation techniques and varieties available in India?
Yes, Mr. Srinivas. Though the jackfruit is propagated by seed traditionally, recently propagation techniques such as enarching and softwood grafting have been found the best methods. Since the viability of seeds is very less, the seeds of jackfruit have been sown immediately after extraction to raise rootstocks. And coming to commercial varieties, in India we grow Swarna Hasalu, Mattivarika, Aninga Hasalu, Rudraksha Paila, Chandra Hasalu, Surya Hasalu, and Rudraksha Hasalu. For getting more economic benefits, farmers have to choose the variety suitable for their regions.
Thank you, Dr. Ravi Kishore, for giving valuable information. Now I request Dr. Saurav Swami, will you brief us about various cultural practices followed for this jackfruit cultivation?
Thank you, Mr. Srinivas. The jackfruit grafts are generally planted in the period of June to September. The grafts are trained to be a height of 1.5 to 2 meter so as to obtain a common trunk. And regarding the irrigation requirement, the plants are very prone to drought, and therefore proper irrigation should be provided at the fruiting and flowering stage.
Thank you, Dr. Saurav Swami, for giving your valuable information regarding the various cultural practices. Now I request Dr. Tarani Das, Could you enlighten our farmers about various pests and diseases occur in jackfruit and their management?
Of course, Mr. Srinivas. Generally, the jackfruit is attacked by very few pests and diseases. Among them, jackfruit borer and jackfruit rot are of major concern. The jackfruit borer, that is brown within, bores into the buds, shoots and fruit. It can be managed by destroying infested plant parts and by spraying with 0.035% of monocrotocus. Among the diseases, the fruit rot caused by rhizopus species is one of the major setbacks in the humid region. Sometimes it causes premature failure of the younger fruits. However, it can be well managed by spraying with 0.25% of diethylene M45 or 0.05% of bathystin at 15 days interval during fruit growth.
Thank you, Dr. Tarinidas, for giving valuable comments on various pests and diseases management. Now I request Dr. Shiva, can you explain about various harvesting and yield details of this jackfruit?
Sure, Mr. Srinivas. Normally, jack start producing fruits from its 7th year, but the grafted one starts producing from its 4th year itself. These fruits are available from March to June. This harvesting stage mainly because of the purpose for which it is going to harvested. And the weight varies from 10 to 30 kg, and the yield of this fruit varies from 20 to 100 per fruit.
Thank you, Dr. Shiva, for giving valuable comments. Now I request Dr. Vijay Rakesh Reddy, will you brief us about various value addition aspects of this jackfruit?
Yes, Srinivas. Actually, the jackfruit has a great potential of value addition. More than 100 items can be prepared from the jackfruit, ranging from immature fruit to the fully ripe fruit. And some of the most popular items prepared from this jackfruit include jackfruit curry, jackfruit chips, jackfruit pakoda, jackfruit jam, jackfruit pickle, jackfruit halwa and jackfruit wine. And each of these products have a special virtue based on its taste, preference and keeping quality.
Thank you, Dr. Vijay Rakesh Reddy, for giving valuable information on different value addition aspects of this fruit. Now once again, I thank you, Dr. Sandeep Kumar, Dr. Saurabh Swami, Dr. Shiva and Dr. Ravi Kishore, Dr. Tarnidas, Dr. Vijay Rakesh Reddy for your presence over here and spending your valuable time in our studio. I hope this information would be quite useful for our farmer friends. For any further details, you can send to our address, Smart Farming, post box number 840, ICAR, NARM, Rajendra Nagar, Hyderabad, Telangana 500030, and you can also send a mail to us, smartfarming@narm.in, and you can also call to our toll free number 1800 088 00. That's all for the day. We will meet tomorrow at the same time in the same channel. Namaste.